Yo, what's poppin'? Brand new whip just happened. So I just finished the gym and I wanted to come and speak to you for like a couple of minutes about an idea that I was having at the gym about consistency. Now, with my roommate, we've been discussing a few things and what we realized is that in certain areas of our life, say for me right now, what we're talking about was gym, social media, social circle, our dating lives, our business lives. Whenever we had success, we had consistency. So every day we turned up. And so you've heard the term, every day you turn up to the office or you just put the hours in, the little terminologies, but what does that actually mean? And what we worked out when discussing was that consistency means prioritizing what you want to achieve. Whenever we had success in certain areas, we put diligent time in and it wasn't just 10 hours one day and then nothing the next. And then maybe a couple of hours and nothing and feel like you're being productive, but you're really not. The idea of consistency is turning up every day and putting relatively same amount of effort, what we've noticed. And we both do e-com, so e-commerce, which is basically selling things online. What I noticed when he became successful in e-commerce was the diligence of turning up every day and putting the same amount of energy, the same amount of thing, always chipping away at it. Now, when I became successful in the dating scene, I put the same amount of energy in every single day and it was day after day after day. And that's where the consistency came from. It didn't matter if it was a Saturday, it didn't matter if it was a Friday night, it didn't matter anything. I turned up every single day and saw little bits of progress. Number two is tracking your progress. Actually understanding that you are getting better, because you can get lost in the idea that you're turning up and but you're not seeing improvements. And you're looking at the bigger picture, like, okay, well, say if you want to get rich, and then you notice you're a couple of months in and you're not rich yet, you're looking at that goal, you're looking where you are, and you're like, well, I'm not at my goal. So you get discouraged and you get disheartened. But if you actually tracked every single week, every single day, every couple of days, I recommend every day, you'll notice over time between you starting and you 3 months in that you're 100% better than when you started. But because you're not at that end goal, you think you haven't improved, but you have when you track it. So that's number two, which is tracking every single thing that you do. So if you take that consistency and break it down a little bit further, a lot of people, this is what happens, is that say if they want to get fit in the gym, say if they want to get a better dating life, say if they want to get more money, they do it a couple of times. Let's take the gym, for instance. You know, you do 100 sit-ups, you go to the gym a couple of times, you do a few workouts, and you look back in the mirror, you look, and you go, well, there's no change, so it mustn't be working. And a lot of times in relationships, when, say, the relationship's going downhill a little bit, is that, okay, I'll buy her some flowers, I'll start to, you know, pick up after myself, I'll start to you know, cook some dinners, and you do it a couple of times, and there's no difference. And you're like, well, it mustn't be working, you know what I mean? And so you give up. So what you have to do is fundamentally believe that the course of action that you are taking, whether that's going to the gym, whether that's improving your relationship, whether that is improving your dating life, whether that is successful in business, whether that's making more money, whether, you know, a whole range of things, is fundamentally believing that the course of action that you are taking to improve yourself is the right course of action. And you have to start to believe in what you're doing. Now, I don't know what day it is. And I don't know what time period is, because, you know, every person is different. But I do know that if you consistently put in the effort and put in the time, you will see results. And I like this analogy. It's like brushing your teeth twice a day, right? The act of brushing your teeth, sure, it gets food, you know, it gets rid of plaque, it gets rid of all sorts of things. But the act of brushing your teeth doesn't really, you don't see much benefit from it. But don't brush your teeth for 6 months and see what happens. So it's the act of the small act of daily tasks that gets you results. And the funny thing is, I was a golfer for a long time, and what I realized is that when I used to play every day, I'm talking day after day, not taking breaks, not a day here, day there, daily actions, every single day, there's something about compound days. I don't know what it is. When you compound days on top of days on top of days on top of weeks and then on top of months, but when you take it day by day by day by day, something happens. And usually, give a time frame so you can hold on to something about the 3 month range. right? Sometimes it's earlier, sometimes it's later. Please don't take that 3 month as a benchmark, but let's say 3 months. It's almost like your brain every day takes little chips away at what you're trying to do to get to your goal. And then it almost puts up barriers to see if you're committed enough to go through with it. Hypothetically, this is not what happens, but hypothetically. But by you pushing those boundaries every day and pushing to do what you want, this is the right course of action. Pushing through business, reading every day. You know, for me, it's meditating every day. It's going to the gym every day. It's talking with strangers every day. It's being social. It's checking up on friends and family every day. It's checking up on myself every day. Putting in work in my businesses. Doing those every day reaps the rewards. Not tomorrow, but if I keep chipping away at it, I get to improve more and more and more. It's kind of like a mentor of mine, Elliot Hull, says, if you improve 1% every day, in 100 days, you're a completely different person. Because you've changed yourself 1% every day. Ask anyone when they fell in love with someone. So ask your parents, your sisters, your brother, they might be married. Ask strangers, ask old people, when did you fall in love with someone? No one will give us a specific date, a specific thing they did. They'll usually always say, you know, it was the way he treats me. He does this, does that. It's not a particular thing. It's an ongoing thing that happens all of the time. The way he makes me laugh. It's not the one specific joke he said in March 21st, you know, 1999. It's the ongoing things. It's the way he makes me feel like a princess, or it's a way she makes me feel strong and powerful, like I can take on the world, right? It's an accumulation of things. It's never that one thing. So it's always about the time and effort you put into it. And people say, okay, well, one day I'll put in, you know, to the gym, I'll do a 9-hour gym session. And then the next day I'm the same size. Why is that? You know, put in 1-hour sessions 9 times in a row, you'll see some progress. Number 3 to consistency, and this is probably what I'll wrap with, is a idea I got from a friend of mine, which was an accountability partner. And he was the very first one to tell me about it. And what I used to do in the dating scene was, when I would see a good looking girl and I'd want to have the urge to approach her and talk to her and see if we vibed, right in the beginning, or even before I didn't learn anything about the dating stuff, I would be scared and never talk to her. And one of the things he said was, when you find a wingman or a friend of yours, you would give him some money, and every time you approached, you would get some money back. And if you didn't, at the end of the day, he got the money. So that's where I learned it from. Another accountability is basically, if you want to get good at something, one of the things that a lot of people talk about is actually getting something that might push your budget a little bit. Whether that is buying a course that teaches you something. You know, it might be stretching your money-wise a little bit. It might be buying the piece of equipment that you're like, okay, well, I'm going to practice so much with it because it cost me a little bit of money. That's an accountability, right? That's you being like, okay, well, I put my assets into something and now I'm going to reap the rewards. And if you have a look, a lot of the time when someone purchases a course, they will suck so much information out of that. And when someone doesn't purchase the course and gets it for free, they won't. And I thought I wasn't like that. I thought, no way. You know what I mean? Again, I got Ty Lopez's 67 Steps. Listened to it, didn't really get anything from it, unfortunately. It was free. You then purchase something, you take every single bit of information from that. That's almost like a final effort. You know what I mean? You can say, you know, if you want to go to the gym, you know, and you get a buddy that goes there every time that I don't go to the gym, I give you $10 or something like that. And it's funny because those things spur you on. You're like, I don't want to lose $10, stuff that, you know, I'm going to turn up there every single day, you know? And you can always play games with that, but that accountability partner really does work, but it's also the final effort. So you do it yourself, and then if that doesn't work, I suggest the accountability partner, because it really does spur you on to get the results that you want. The consistency comes with prioritizing how much you want this by defining your goal or what you want. I want to lose 20 pounds, okay? That's your goal, which is good. That's your why, and you definitely got to have a why. That's your why. What is it going to take to me to get there? And then understand that you just have to put that effort in every day. Some days it's going to be good, some days it's going to be bad. And then after a while, what happens is it's almost like it becomes a habit. You become a little bit numb to it, and you just, it's part of your day. It's part of what you do. So it's a little bit longer than 2 minutes, or 3 minutes that I said it was, but hopefully you got something from it. Anyways, peace out.